The Guildford Design Award for the conservation project Public Building goes to West Horsley Place and this phase of work in the northwest restrooms. This is another successfully completed phase of a series of projects gradually restoring this beautiful Grade 1 listed building. The judges were very pleased to see the concept of this building with its minimal interventions, and the new WC cubicles are treated as pieces of furniture, allowing the various layers of the original building to sit within the space. I'm here today with Simon Goddard, the conservation specialist, who worked together with David Lloyd-Jones on this wonderful conservation project. And I'm going to be asking them a few key questions. So Simon, when you started, what were the main objectives that you wanted to achieve?
These rooms were originally quite high status rooms, but over time they became used as workshops, and by the time we started the project about 3 years ago, they were used as workshops and storage rooms, and they were quite untidy, filled with all sorts of rubbish and junk. So when the house became opened up for public events and public use and visits, they needed somewhere to have their toilets and their restrooms. So this was seemed to be, to us, to be one of the immediately obvious places we might put it.
And when you were underway with the project, what were the real challenges that you encountered and had to solve in making this building?
But as we started to peel away those layers, we found the natural fact that we had to respond to these different aspects that we were finding along the way. The principal challenges is that the space that we're in currently was divided into a whole series of much smaller cellular spaces. And as we took down some of these walls with their sort of their modern plasterboard and various other sort of finishes, we found new steels in the positions where we thought that we could actually put some of the new loos. So we had to change and adapt as we were finding things. We found this fireplace, for example, which was always going to be behind the toilets, and we had to respond by moving them to the opposite side of the room. So each time we were uncovering new things, our approach had to change to respond to that.
And this really creative idea of keeping the new cubicles as furniture, what gave you the idea for that real concept?
Well, when we've got historic buildings, and particularly ones which are as important as this, what we want to do is do as little to interfere with the historic fabric as possible. So we reused holes that were already there for services. We put vents through holes through lath and plaster walls. And the idea of furniture was that this may not always be the use of these particular rooms. So if we could actually take them away when these changes, we would have done as little harm to the building as possible. So that was where it was all about the lightness of touch to the existing fabric.
And now that you're coming back to the building, which aspects of it give you the greatest delight?
What we've been able to do is reveal far more of the history of the building and its development than we ever envisaged. So really it's those questions and people sort of saying you really must go and see these particular spaces have been fantastic, both for the house and for us. We've decided to try and allow people to ask questions of what they're seeing rather than to sort of cover it in explanatory notes, because it's really about setting in sort of the questions really for us to be able to help them answer about why these rooms were like this, how they've developed, why the walls are like they are, and we can then introduce them to the rest of the history of the house.